Hollywood, 1936. George Gershwin moved into a Spanish-style mansion with a swimming pool and, more importantly, a tennis court. Not far away lived Arnold Schoenberg. He was 62 years old and had recently moved to America to escape Nazi Germany. Schoenberg had a great teaching job with many high-profile composition students and was working on his difficult violin concerto. Gershwin was busy writing the score to the hit musical Shall We Dance? Even though their music was completely different, Gershwin admired Schoenberg. He even considered studying music theory with him. But when Gershwin met Schoenberg, at the home of his neighbor, Shirley Temple, his overture to the older composer was decidedly non-musical. He challenged Schoenberg to a friendly game of tennis. Well, one match became two, and two became a whole lot more. Tennis turned into a weekly ritual for the composers. Schoenberg often brought a small entourage of string players and conductors. Gershwin invited his songwriter friends like Harold Arlen and Yip Harburg. The composers' techniques on the court were apparently as different as their music, which in Gershwin's case was linear, direct. While Schoenberg was more, you know, Schoenbergian. Gershwin's game was described as nonchalant, relentless, and chivalrous. Schoenberg's as overly eager and choppy. But they enjoyed playing together so much that they never missed a match. Schoenberg even showed up to play on the day his son Ronald was born. Today we might call that a major husband fail.